And here is a look at that Rhode Island starting lineup. Making his first start since November 23rd, of course, without Brian Freeman, is the sophomore Sebastian Thomas. He's joined by Carey and Ishmael Leggett, along with Malik Martin. And the big man, Alex Chiku, of course, led by Archie Miller in his first year leading the Rhode Island Rams. On the other end of things for VCU, they're sticking with their same starting lineup from their last time out, led by one of the best point guards in the Atlantic 10, Ace Baldwin Jr. He's joined by Jaden Nunn, Nick Curran Jr., and then in the front court, you got Jalen Deloach and the Michigan transfer, Brandon Johns Jr., led by the head man back in his sixth year now as head coach after returning to VCU, Mike Rhodes. And there he is, 8 postseason appearances with VCU. Rams have been good at home. They've won 6 out of their last 8, or 7 rather, here in the Ryan Center, and we are underway. VCU will get the first touch. Of course, the VCU Rams coming off a defeat and a week of rest they have not played since last Tuesday night. It was a 62-58 defeat at the Siegel Center to the Dayton Flyers, a team that the Rhode Island Rams did defeat here, right here on this floor.
Yeah, Rhode Island's been very good at home, and they're going to need to be spectacular tonight, Zach, if they want to play and play well against this team.
Here's Kern Jr. looking for the pass for Deloach. It goes out of bounds. It was deflected, so we'll stay with VCU.
Yeah, one of the things that I want to talk about, Zach, we'll see how long Chiku stays in there. The big this year for Rhode Island has been very up and down. We'll see what it's like tonight.
Chiku making his 4th consecutive start in the starting lineup and his 10th in a row as Rhode Island gets the stop on that possession. Here's their first touch on offense. Thomas right away. He'll drive inside. Leggett for 3. Kisses off the front of the rim. VCU now has it in transition.
Maybe got away with a little bit of carry there, Zach. Looks like it came up, but now wide open.
That's Jaden Nunn. No good for him. 36% from 3, but couldn't get that one to fall. Thomas again running the show at point guard. His first start in a while, his 7th on the season, and Archie Miller said it back on Monday. His role is going to continue to grow, of course, with the vacant position left by Brayon Freeman. Here's Leggett on the handoff, and he's bumped. Contact will draw the foul from Kern.
I tell you what, Leggett, he does the little things, Zach. A lot of times you hear coaches talk about, hey, you got to rub off the screen. It seems so simple, but right there, he comes so close off the screen that you see the contact, and right there, you give a guy a foul, and you get your team to set up on the offensive end.
Again, we mentioned it in the open. The Rams are coming off 3 straight losses, all on the road. Again, they're now 0-9 in road games with just a couple left. Here's Carey on the swing pass. The Rams just 8 seconds now on the shot clock. Jalen Carey gets the screen, makes a move. 2 seconds now to shoot. Rhode Island has to get one up. And it does. Jalen Carey sinks it with just tenths of a second left on the shot clock. Rhode Island gets the first points of the ballgame.
Talk about composure there from Jalen Carey. Exactly what you want to see.
Here is Ace Baldwin. He's been the VCU's leading point scorer in the last 4 games. He misses the rim on that shot. Second tip up to no avail. Rhode Island gets it back. Thomas stutter step at the free throw line. He'll kick it out. He'll find the hands once again of Jalen Carey. Chiku hands to Thomas. Wide open look. He'll pass it up. Martin makes his way inside. Euro step and gets the foul.
Zach, right now what Rhode Island is doing is they're giving up good looks for great looks. It's unselfish basketball. The ball is moving better than I think I've seen it in most cases this year, but especially at the Ryan Center here. This is a huge way to start this game, and free throws, I cannot emphasize it enough. They are critical, and Rhode Island has really struggled this year from the free throw line.
Although it is Noah, as that one rolls in, one of their better free throw shooting years in a while. It's something that Rhode Island hasn't been necessarily known for.
Yes.
In this, coming into this game now, 3rd in the Atlantic 10 at 74.4%. Here's Malik Martin at the line, shooting about 61 this year. Again, now over 1,000 points in his collegiate career. Hit that early in the month of January. He gets both of those shots to fall. Rhode Island now up 4-0. Brandon Johns, again, the Michigan transfer, will get that one to Nunn. He gets the bump from Jalen Carey. A couple of early fouls in this game. Now it's Rhode Island's first, though. And bring his side out.
Yeah, you can see Archie Miller over there not happy with Jalen Carey on that one. Tell him, hey, you got to move your feet. These are the type of, you know, tic-tac fouls, Zach, that you or I cannot afford to pick up early.
Baldwin has it on the near side. He'll float it up ahead to the bucket. Johns lays it up off the window. It's VCU's first points of the night. Brandon Johns, one of the players Archie Miller mentioned earlier this week, a big focal point. Someone that he's very familiar with as well, many matchups between Indiana and Michigan during Archie's time with the Hoosiers. Carey lost it off his foot, and he's going to pick it up, but it's a backcourt violation. Sloppy mistake there for the Rams.
Yeah, Zach, right there again, you talk about these little things. It all adds up. Right now, it might not seem like a lot, but if this game were to come down to the wire, those things, they matter.
VCU very good at forcing those turnovers. That one, though, Rhode Island forced on their own. Here's Johns for three, and that one's good. Brandon Johns Jr. with the last 5 points for VCU. Take the lead 5-4. On the season, he's just over 24% from beyond the arc. That one, though, nothing but the bottom of the net. Here's Sebastian Thomas, nice feed underneath for Alex Jiku, and he slams it home.
Yeah, that's a great job there by Sebastian Thomas. He's patient, he gets it, he's not flustered by that last three-point basket, and finds his open man.
Jiku himself is coming off a career-best game, his first game in double figures, a 10-point outing at George Mason back on Saturday. Floater in the paint, one-on-one, Deloach floats it up, but no good. Malik Martin secures the rebound for the Rhode Island Rams. Push pass from Thomas. Here's Carey, another touch, fighting his way inside. Nearly got the roll, though, but not able to get that one to go. Nunn pushes it to Johns. Will he take another one? Not that time. Ball rolling around. VCU getting to it. Archie Miller wishing someone would have just ran to that ball.
Yeah, he just pointed that ball and said, guys, somebody come and get this before I run out on the court and get it myself.
Another chance for VCU. Deloach couldn't get that layup to go, but instead the foul. That'll bring us to our first media timeout of the game. Rhode Island scored the first 4 points, but then Brandon Johns got it going. Here's a nice feed. Jiku slams it home for two. Welcome back to the Ryan Center. Rams up 6-5. Let's send it to the third member of our crew, Paige Messier.
Thank you, Zach. As you guys said before, Breon Freeman was dismissed from the team earlier this week, and following that decision, head coach Archie Miller, he said that although he's not on the team any longer, he will support Breon's academic health and wellness while he's part of the university. Well, in big picture standpoint, it was the best move for the team. Where does that leave the team now? Well, Coach Miller expressed he sees a new role for Sebastian Thomas, who will have to handle the ball a little bit more with some extended minutes, and Jalen Carey will have to step more into a point guard role. And he has to limit his turnovers, but he's excited to see what Jalen does defensively with this new role. Back to you, Zach.
Thank you, Paige. And we've already seen both of them make some plays in this game. Carey got the first 2 points for the Rams, and then that nice feed from Thomas we just saw before the break got two for Jiku.
Yeah, you're absolutely right, Zach. Both guys are already stepping up. They realize, you know, and I said it a couple of times, but I'm just going to go back to it again. It's a next guy up mentality, and Archie Miller is a guy that has a lot of experience in this college basketball game, and he will do whatever it takes to get this team in the best position to win ball games.
Deloach first free throw is good. Now Sebastian Thomas, again, he got the first 6 starts of the season and has since then been off the bench, but that third start of the year, it was the Rams' first win against Stony Brook. It was a career best game, a double-double. He had 13 points, 10 assists. Played 38 minutes in that one. We'll see if he has a similar level of production, or at least in a volume-wise, here tonight. Both free throws up and through for, or rather one of two that time went Deloach. So a tie ball game here at 6. Here's a drive for Leggett going up strong. Second chance for the Rams. Jiku didn't get that one to roll through. Here comes VCU. Baldwin, laser pass and rejected by Jiku. Some impact plays from the big man, but VCU still alive with it. Floater from Deloach, a couple of them, and finally rebound secured for the Rams here, and Jiku brings it down.
I tell you what, Jiku wanted nothing to do with that, and they are great defense by the big fella.
Skying up to get that one was Carey, and you know that's why Chiku's earned his place back in the starting lineup. Again, fourth consecutive start here tonight is a fadeaway from Carey. No, and Johns gets the rebound for VCU. VCU Rams have missed their last 5 shots. Rhode Island has missed their last 4. We're knotted up here at 6.
Not a team settling into any offensive rhythm just yet here, Zach.
Drive inside. Johns working around Malik Martin. He gets the layup up and through. Brandon Johns has scored all but 1 point for VCU so far. They're up 8-6. Rams trying to snap a 2-minute 15-plus scoring drought on this possession. Martin tries to move to the near side, and he finds Sebastian Thomas. He's still looking for his first points. That's deflected in the air, out of bounds, off Deloach. Leave Rhodey with 6 seconds left on the shot clock. Here's a look on the other end. Brandon Johns dominating here for VCU.
Yeah, I tell you what, he's so good inside, Zach. And the thing is he can shoot it outside as well. And that's what makes him so dangerous. He's so lanky and just able to get to the rim. 12 points, 5 rebounds per game. That's what you're looking at for the season stats.
We also saw that three-pointer from him. That was his first points as Martin couldn't find the bucket, but then the put away is good for the Rams. They tie back up at 8. There's Leggett getting on the scoreboard. So his first 2 points of the night in the game is Zeb Jackson, another Michigan transfer, coming over along with Brandon Johns. Here he is underneath, once again battling against Chiku, and a travel call against VCU. Chiku seemed to have won that battle the last couple possessions.
Yeah, Chiku's been doing a wonderful job. He's going to get a short breather here as Abdu Sam will check in. But I tell you what, Zach, that's exactly what Archie Miller and these Rams need from him. Wall him up, let him make the mistakes, and don't force anything that you don't need to. He's a big guy. Play good defense. We know he can.
Again, as you said, Noah, much needed rest for Abdu Sam, or excuse me, for Alex Chiku, Abdu Sam in to take his place. Some pressure put on by VCU. This is something that they do a lot. And it's surely something they'll continue to do throughout the night.
And David Shriver, maybe check your ankle braces, my friend. Looks like he was a little sturdy playing defense over there.
Shriver into the game for VCU as well as Rhode Island with 6 seconds to shoot. They got to get something going here. Martin inside, kick out. Thomas from the corner, got it to go. Sebastian Thomas gets a three-pointer with time expiring, and he's now on the board.
And the hometown guy firing up the Ryan Center here, early going.
Again, a hometown hero, hails from Providence, Rhode Island, returned to the program despite the coaching change last year, and again, figures to be huge for the Rams down the stretch. Jackson into the game, two defenders on him. Now VCU, time winding on the shot clock. Shriver will take it from downtown. The Rams secure it on the boards. Here comes Thomas again. Thought about the look. He'll hold on to it. Just make the move inside. Backdoor. Couldn't finish. It's Rams, Rhode Island, that is still with it. And eventually the foul call.
And that is just great hustle mentality right there. Let's watch this Sebastian Thomas three again. This is at the buzzer, mind you. Great kick out from Martin. And look at that as time expires. Nothing but net, never a doubt from the hometown hero.
And after that last possession, Abdu Sam will head to the free throw line. Again, into the game now for Chiku. His last two games each had a season low 4 minutes. He started a good portion of the game for Rhodey this year. 17 starts and his 24 appearances coming in. As ECU makes a slew of changes. Sam on the season, averaging 4.5 points per game at the line, shooting 75%. Redshirt freshman, again, returned from last year. He didn't get any playing time. Said, let's give it another shot back here with Kingston for his second season. Gets that second one to go, makes the bottom half of his free throw attempts. Rams now up by 4 over the first place VCU squad, 12-8. Back to the game is Nick Kern Jr. Jackson drives, he slipped, poked away by Thomas. It's out of bounds, but it'll stay with VCU.
Yeah, and you see that bench electric over there, Zach. This is really an opportunity for Rhode Island to take this momentum here back at the Ryan Center. As we mentioned earlier, 3 consecutive road losses. Rhode Island needs a win here.
That last free throw by Sam. Now Rhode Island on a 6-0 run over the last minute, 45 seconds or so. VCU, they haven't scored in nearly 2.5 minutes. 2 seconds to shoot. Something needs to go here for VCU. They get a shot off. Not in time, though, as Kern did not get it off before the shot clock expired. Rhode Island forces the stop, and they'll head into the timeout up 4. Rhode Island score the last six. They're looking strong here in the first half. Back here at the Ryan Center, Rams up by four. Zach Austin, Noah McClain, and Noah, you know, Rams, again, as we mentioned, coming off that three-game, you know, road skid, they lost all three of their games, but they're looking comfortable already here at home.
Well, Zach, they're looking more than comfortable. They're looking fantastic, dare I say, but it is early on, but Rhode Island, the key is to get out early and keep that momentum because it's easy to start, but the hard thing for Rhode Island this year has been to go the whole distance of the way. We've seen so many close games, but Rhode Island early, as we talked about, Archie Miller very happy with their defensive side. Defense leads the offense, and like I said earlier, the ball movement has been really good for the Rams so far tonight.
Ace Baldwin to start this game is 0 of 2. Deloach is 0 of 3. He does have a point off a free throw, but 7 of VCU's 8 points have come from Brandon Johns.
Yeah, Rhode Island shooting it fairly well from the charity stripe as well. And right after that last one, they said no shot, so it was a shot clock violation. Rhode Island will get the basketball to start.
VCU to begin this game, 3 of 12 from the floor. Rhode Island is 4 of 11, and they're on a 6-0 run looking to extend it here. Sebastian Thomas at point guard so far, made a few key plays here early on. Jalen Carey looking to spin around or find the outlet to Martin. Rhode Island shot clock down to 6. Thomas spinning in the lane, puts up a turnaround jumper, no good. Jackson has it now for VCU. Deloach is another key player to Archie Miller mentioned back on Monday. Someone that can get it going in the post. He'll have it here on this possession. Thomas pokes the ball away and he dives on it. Great effort by Thomas, but just out of his reach and then out of bounds. We'll stay with VCU, but there's the hustle plays that Sebastian Thomas has been making here for Rhode Island.
That's the second or third time, Zach, that we've seen Sebastian Thomas really just, it's the help side defense. He comes from behind and just knocks it away. And the key thing is he's not swiping down at the ball. He's coming up and knocking it away. Great job by Sebastian Thomas.
VCU had 10, now 9 seconds. Is that one on the shot clock? That is that one bats right back out of bounds. And here, back into the game now, is Ace Baldwin, who, you know, his stats precede him, needs no introduction. How about 37 points against, at the time, the second-best team in the A-10, St. Louis, at their place a couple weeks back?
Yeah, well, he's phenomenal.
Shattered his career high, previously was 28. Here's Kern, shot clock expired, he didn't even get a shot up. Nothing going here for VCU. Rhode Island locking it down.
And that's the second time that he's had the basketball in his possession, Zach, and hasn't been aware. My famous saying, or well, I shouldn't say mine, but I love to say it, situational awareness is what you have to have in that situation. I'd rather see maybe get up a shot, a little pull-up jumper. That's in his capability. But again, not aware of the clock.
More press from VCU. Thomas able to cross half court. VCU scoring drought now is extended past 3.5 minutes. Rhodey has scored the last 6 points. Well, we haven't seen some points now in about 3 minutes or so. That one's batted away by Deloach. Sam's able to stay with it. Here's Martin one-on-one of the basket, and then Carey with the putback for Rhode Island. Now 8 in a row for the home team.
Jalen Carey, what a nice job elevating above the rim for that putback.
Deloach with it. Toss it out in front for Baldwin. Thought about the three instead, he'll get it to the near side. Here's Deloach taking his time. Abdu Sam nearly poked away again. That time was Martin, and the foul forced by Rhode Island that time. But we've seen that a couple times now where Deloach turns around Rhode Island there to try and swipe it away.
Yeah, and Martin came over and did a nice job again. Let's watch this one more time. Carey again off this. So good. The elevation and the finish for Jalen Carey.
Carey 4 points on the night so far with 2 boards in his 8 minutes. And VCU looking to snap their scoring drought now of 4 minutes, 23 seconds with these free throws from Deloach. Already has one up a free throw. He missed his first.
This is once again just Rhode Island making, you know, VCU work for their points act. Even though you pick up a foul there, you got to make him earn it underneath.
Deloach is now 1 of 3 from the line. He'll have another one coming up as Brandon Johns is back into the game, looking to give a big boost to VCU again. He has 7 of their 8 points right now. Make it 7 of their 9 points as Deloach sinks his second free throw. snaps the 4 minute 23 second scoring drought. 14-9 is Rhode Island's lead. Dunn putting press on Thomas. Crossover. And again, you know, VCU, knowing Thomas hasn't started a whole lot this year, perhaps putting more press on than they usually do. Here's Leggett with the extension, and there's the offensive foul.
I tell you what, it definitely was an extension, but one of the things I hate is when guys are flopping, and really right there, that was just clearly some dramatic flopping right there.
Then again, if you're the officials and you see that arm out, you're going to get the call pretty much every time.
Oh, it's definitely a foul. There's no doubt about that.
Officials for today's game, Jeffrey Clark, Clarence Armstrong, and Jeffrey Anderson. Into the game for the first time is Jameer Watkins. Get it to Nunn. Johns, his first touch since re-entering. He works around everybody in the paint. Doesn't get that one with a cleanup. The finish is good for VCU on the second chance. Archie Miller trying to argue for that travel call. He's not going to get it.
I tell you what, Zach, I'm here for a reason, and the officials are out there for a reason. But, man, I agree with Archie Miller on that one. It looked like he took 4 or 5 steps to get to the basket.
Leggett now on the other end for Rhode Island, whose lead is now 3, 14-11. Weston strong to the bucket, and it gets stuck. That one got stuck between the rim and the backboard. It'll be a jump ball.
And tough there for Weston. That's a great take. Just wasn't able to get it up over the hump there. Let's watch this one more time. Yeah, I mean, look to me like maybe a little, I don't know, that was close, Zach. But again, regardless, 2 points on the board. The lead down to 3 for Rhode Island.
Now Rhode Island's offense trying to get back in the flow of things. Good contest there from Baldwin. Carey finds Leggett. He'll just take the 3 spot up. And it goes off the top of the iron. Rebound by Rhode Island. Same isn't able to finish that time. VCU a chance to tie here on this possession. Driving. Watkins rejected out of bounds. But the foul comes first.
And that's tough right there for Jalen Carey. I think he did get him there, Zach, with the body. It looked like he got him at the last minute. And then, you know, that's always frustrating, especially as a big right there, as you saw the help come over from Chiku, or maybe that, my apologies, that was Sam down there who swatted that away. But again, at least make him earn it from the charity stripe.
It's Jameer Watkins, the redshirt sophomore from Trenton, New Jersey. He has his first rollout that time. Missed last year with a torn ACL. Coming back this year, he's played in all 25 games.
Yeah, he's had some really big minutes, especially after coming back off an injury. And we say it all the time, but you never like to see a guy or a girl for any reason miss time from what they put so much hard work into. So good to see him back into this lineup for VCU.
VCU is now 3 for 6 from the charity stripe as they make, or as Watkins rather, makes his second free throw. And quick foul as Thomas handled it there in the backcourt. That's something that head coach Mike Rhodes spoke about earlier this week. He says his team's been working on their free throws. They're averaging over 70% on the season. But tonight, just 50%. Weston now handling it, trying to get around Watkins. Now splitting, trying to split 3 defenders. He lost the ball. VCU gets it on the turnover in transition. Baldwin, that 3 is blocked and deflected away.
Sebastian Thomas right there does a nice job off of that miss, Zach, getting the ball and says, hey guys, let's slow it down, let me set my stuff up.
Rhode Island has missed 6 of their last 7 shots. On the other end, VCU 8 of their last 10. Been over 2 minutes since Rhode Island has scored. Leggett breaks the defender's ankles. The 3, yes, for Ishmael Leggett. What a move.
And somebody call the doctor, because there are broken ankles here in the Ryan Center.
Rhode Island's lead is up to 5, 17-12. That one's batted away. Back in the game is Alex Chiku. He steals it to the bucket. He lost the handle. But Rhode Island able to secure it cleanly. Big impact play, though, regardless, from Chiku.
Great hands in the passing lane. And then Martin there, Zach. Great job to slow it down, set it back up.
Feed from Leggett. Martin will instead kick it back to the corner. He'll step inside the 3-point line, count the bucket, and the foul. Ishmael Leggett does it again.
Ishmael Leggett has sent this place into an electric shockwave. Let's watch this again as Leggett knocks it down, and he's doing it all here at the Ryan Center.
Back from the break, Rams up by 7. Well, we'll send it courtside to Paige.
Thank you, Zach. Now, the Ryan Center does something very special for this URI team this year. When you look back at the standings, Dayton is at number 2, and Fordham is at number 3. Now, the Rams have beat those two teams in the Ryan Center this year. VCU standing at number 1 is the only one of the top 3 that the Rams have not beat, and a great start for the Rams today. Back to you.
Thank you, Paige. And, you know, Noah, I was thinking the same thing. You know, Rhode Island's had a lot of success in this building against quality opponents this year.
Yeah, they've been very good at the Ryan Center. And I tell you what, Rhode Island as a whole has been phenomenal at the Ryan Center. Obviously, the women undefeated here at the Ryan Center, but the men have also in recent been very, very phenomenal as Leggett misses the chance at the three-point let play the old-fashioned way.
Rhode Island still up 7 here over VCU. Again, Ace Baldwin in this game is still scoreless. He's 0-3 from the floor. Shriver gets it back to Baldwin. Try to drive in, no room though. Driving Kern Jr. Quick layup up and through.
Rhode Island shooting 50% from downtown, Zach, behind the arc. And they're not a huge three-point shooting team, so that's big. Actually, VCU coming into this game is more of the three-point threat. As whistle and a foul will blow this one dead.
That was batted away by Baldwin, but quickly fouling is VCU that time. So Rhode Island will stay with it. Ishmael Leggett, by the way, now Rhode Island's points leader here. 7 points, 3 of 6 shooting at that big three. Him and Johns leading the way here in this one. Thomas with a head of steam to the bucket, gets the layup and the foul. And he beat him, man. Just used that pure speed to get to the basket.
Sebastian Thomas, it's the simple thing, Zach. It was a simple crossover, get to the basket. Let's watch it here. Just beats his defender, as you said. Finishes with the left hand, a little kiss off the glass. And that was smooth like summer butter.
Jaden Nunn did all he could to keep up with him, but Thomas was just too fast. Now go to the free throw line, looking to make it a three-point play, and he does. How about 6 points for Sebastian Thomas in his first start since late November?
Well, we talked about his need to step up tonight, and he's done exactly that, Zach.
Rhode Island now showing some press. Malik Martin will now back off. Johns and Baldwin both in. Johns, VCU point leader with 7, sets the screen for Ace. Baldwin tries to laser it in for him, passes offline, batted in the air a few times, still going, and eventually rolls out at the corner, but ultimately last touch by Leggett will stay with VCU.
Well, I tell you what, Zach, I am absolutely baffled in the fact that VCU did not come away with a wide open layup right there, because Rhode Island was throwing that basketball all over the place, but great job. Nonetheless, it's the little things, the little tips, the little points, pokeaways rather, that just prevented that bucket there.
Johns gets it on the inbound. Baldwin still looking for his first points. Trying to work around Thomas. Driving his Kern. That time, no easy layup, but the foul. Tried the same play they did last time, Noah. That time, a chance for some points at the line.
Nice strong take inside there. And he's gone to the basket a couple times, trying to get his rhythm. Hasn't been in much of a flow tonight.
That's Nick Curran Jr. out of St. Louis, Missouri, sophomore year at the free throw line this year, about 61%. He's also played in all 25 games for the visiting Rams.
Yeah, this is a young guy that's going to play a lot of big minutes in the upcoming years if he decides to stay. But wherever he is, Zach, I feel, you know, stands at 6'6". He's got a quick, you know, movement. He's good going to the basket, and we talked about that pull-up jumper is nice. I love it from that mid-range specialty as he knocked down the first one and has one more here.
Well, no, when you look at the starting lineup, obviously you have Ace Baldwin. He's just a junior. Brandon Johns, the grad transfer, as he misses the second half, ball still going, and Weston getting in the way, but VCU still alive. Kern able to lay it up and through. VCU active on that basketball, and they secured big bucket that time, cutting the lead back to 5. To get back to that point, Noah, you know, look at this lineup. 3 out of 5 are sophomores, including Kern. Now at 5 points, he's perfect, 2 of 2 so far. Brody, though, speaking of perfect, they made all 3 of their last 3 shots. Here's Leggett driving in, the kick out. Fake by Martin, he'll fire up a 3. Weston nearly keeping it alive, but instead it's wrestled away by Josh Banks into the game. for VCU. Baldwin to the bucket. No. Secured on the board by Chiku. Rhode Island has it on the move. Kick out by Thomas. Leggett going up. Hits the ground hard, but it'll go to the line.
Yeah, right there. That's the restricted area. I believe that's the reason why. Maybe he was falling backwards. But nice job there by Leggett. Sebastian Thomas, I would like to see him take that to the basket there, Zach. It looked like he was going to have a lane. But nonetheless, get it to the guy that now is your leading scorer on this Rhode Island squad, as he's got seven already, looking to knock down two from the charity stripe right here.
Get to your point, Noah, about Thomas, though. I'm sure, you know, going into this game and really all season, he's been told, allow your playmakers to make some plays. He got it to Leggett that time. He has two of Rhode Island's four assists to begin the game. As it looks like Chica will head back in. Abdu Sam re-enters for Rhode Island. Chica in this game, some impact minutes. 10 now in the starting lineup. 2 points, but 4 rebounds. Has a block in there as well. Leggett makes the first half as Rhode Island is now in the bonus. VCU, 7 fouls here now in the first half.
Yeah, this is big. It's 5:16 still left in this first half. Rhode Island, you know, again, 70% from the charity stripe. Got to take advantage of every single opportunity they get.
Leggett, 82.5% on the year. He makes both. And it's a 7-point lead once again for Rhode Island. 24-17 as we're nearing the 5-minute mark here in the first. Johns out now and Deloach back in for VCU. Deloach setting the screen. Shriver, a deep three. Nearly got it rimmed out.
That's what he's in there to do, Zach. He's going to catch and he's going to shoot.
Shriver this year, very good from three-point land, 38.5%. Again, graduate transferred out of Hartford. He started at D2, moved his way all the way up to a very successful VCU program. Leggett had the ball and he was fouled there by Jackson.
Yeah, you saw him as soon as he came up from that right there. He pointed to his face like, hey, I just got bumped right in the face. But again, to go back to your point about Shriver, that's just a hard-working man right there as he worked his way up. He battled again. You mentioned was at Hartford and, you know, a program that's in the works again, to say the least. And boy, has he really found his rhythm here at VCU. Spoken very high of by this VCU team.
How about Sebastian Thomas finding his rhythm? He heads to the bench with 6 points. Meanwhile, Leggett on a 1-1 makes the first half, so he'll get another. 15 minutes for Thomas again back in the starting lineup due to now the absence for the remainder of the year for Brayon Freeman, no longer with Rhode Island's program. Leggett makes the second half. 2 of 2 on that trip, and Rhode Island's lead is continuing to climb. Their largest now of the night at 9 points.
We talked about the leadership of Jalen Carey and Sebastian Thomas. Jalen Carey back into this ball game, but Leggett needs to step up as well, and he's done just that.
Jackson finds Shriver. He'll pass it off. Driving is Banks. Spinning in the paint. He'll throw it up with the right hand, but the foul. So Josh Banks into the game out of Charlotte, North Carolina. We'll head to the line. Didn't play a lot against Rhode Island. Just 1 minute in the matchup between these two teams last season. Standing at 6'5". He's at the line. Very good free throw shooter for them in his minutes. Over 81%. VCU also in the bonus. Rhode Island's hit 7 fouls. Sebastian Thomas quickly re-enters.
Yeah, Banks is a guy that has a lot of composure. He's not the biggest of dudes underneath there, but you saw there, it was his patience and good footwork that led him to get to the charity stripe. And as you mentioned, a very good free throw shooter, and shows us why right there as he knocks down both of them.
Perfect trip in his first of the night is Josh Banks. It's a 7-point game once again, 26-19. Spinning and trying to cross half court is Carey. He lost the ball and ultimately a blocking foul against Zeb Jackson that leaves Mike Rhodes confused.
I tell you what, Zach, that is a... Jalen Carey is going to walk away very lucky out of that one, because in my mind, that was not much contact there. And right there, you saw it was the defensive pressure as VCU down a few and trying to get some explanations still here. Baldwin Jr. talking to the official.
By the way, back to Josh Banks. This is his first appearance since January 31st. He hasn't played in a minute. Now in mid-February here at the line. This time is Jalen Carey. He makes his first. carry, 83% this year. Again, we talked about it. Started his career at Syracuse in a Rhode Island uniform. His career high last time out, 21 points, averaging just under 10 on the season. He makes both. Lead is back to 9 here for the home Rams. How about the job that Rhode Island's done on Ace Baldwin here today? 0-4 so far in the first half. He'll drive it inside. Thomas in front. He picks up the foul. Now a chance, perhaps, for Baldwin to get on the scoreboard.
Yeah, right there, Baldwin. I think he heard you when you said that there, Zach. He said, all right, you want to talk some smack? I'll go right to the rim and show you why I'm one of the best players in this conference. But, you know, obviously just going hard at Sebastian Thomas and now has a chance to knock it down. 37 points, as we mentioned, in that LaSalle game earlier this year against a very, very good LaSalle team as he knocks that one down.
About 12 out of 15 from the floor out at Shea Fetz Arena. And again, that one's premier, one of the premier games in the A-10. You had VCU and St. Louis vying for first place in that one. It's Baldwin's first is through. It's a clean 81% on the season. His second also rolls home. 7-point advantage for the Rams. It's been hovering around that mark for most of the half. Rhode Island, though, has not hit a field goal in over 2.5 minutes.
It's going to be important for Sebastian Thomas to stay composed right now. They don't need to get anything quick, but don't take your foot off the gas at the same time.
Carey looking to shake out Shriver. Nearly lost it, but he gets it back. 9 seconds on the shot clock for Sebastian Thomas. Two defenders closing on him quickly. Wide open underneath is Sam. He couldn't get a handle of it. 1 second on the shot clock. Martin fires up a last-ditch heave, and it's no good. Missed opportunity there for Rhode Island.
Yeah, Abdu Sam right there, Zach. Missed a wide-open slam. That should have been a highlight reel dunk as we got a whistle, and a player is down on the court. This is not good for the VCU Rams.
I believe that's Jalen Deloach. And we're going to come to a break. We hope Deloach is all right. We'll get you an update when we come back. Well, not the sight you want to see if you're a VCU. That's Jalen Deloach being helped off the court. You can't put any weight on that left leg. They were looking at his left knee, and this is just not something you want to see here tonight, Noah.
Oh, no. I mean, from any level, any player, it doesn't matter, home, away, no matter what, you never want to see it. Let's take a look at the injury here. He goes up for the rebound and comes down. Oh, you can see him grimace right away. It's that left knee that he comes down on. Let's watch it again. Goes up and, oh, man, yep, you saw it just kind of bend awkwardly. Never something that you want to see as a player right there. And we just hope and pray that he is okay. And certainly a valuable player for this VCU roster. But regardless, as we said, the bigger thing, forget the player. Right now it's about the person, Zach. We just hope he's all right.
And that would be a big loss if he can't return, whether it's tonight or, you know, beyond this game. VCU's leader in rebounds, over 7 a game. He has the most blocks out of all VCU Rams with 31. 4 double-doubles on the year, and, you know, that's just, you know, if you lose him, that's huge.
I mean, 4 double-doubles, he goes up, he's a great rim protector, he does the little things. He is a very big, just a guy with a lot of heart, Zach, that is going to be missed for however long he's out there. But again, we mentioned, we just hope he's A-okay as soon here. But it will be VCU basketball right now, as they will get possession with a fresh shot clock, rather.
Jalen Deloach, again, the sophomore out of Savannah, Georgia, out of the game for VCU. They'll get the basketball back here, down by 7. Both teams in the bonus. Driving is Brandon Johns. He'll push it on up and through over the head of Malik Martin.
Well, that just seemed too easy right there.
Here's the press again from VCU. Rams lead down to 5. Thomas will draw up a play. Right now, points leader in this game is Ish Leggett with 11 points. Only player in double figures in this game. Martin gets it on the handoff with 8 seconds on the shot clock. I'll set the screen for Carey. Carey, so they can move. Ball movement. Leggett in the corner has to put it up. And falling out of bounds, he pushes it with the right hand. It'll be a shot clock violation. Or no, a foul.
Yeah, I was going to say, I think he got fouled there. That's the right call for sure, as Leggett once again just finding ways to make stuff happen just when it seems like nothing is going to go right for him.
Rhode Island catching a break there now in the double bonus. Ish Leggett, again, we just mentioned 11 points back at the free throw line. 4 of 5 in this game.
Yeah, 4 of 5 from the charity stripe as he knocks that one down right there. And Leggett has really come alive in the last few minutes, Zach, as we will see Sam take a seat. And Chiku will step back in for some more minutes down the stretch for Rhode Island.
And another positive is Leggett makes his second back in that George Mason game on Saturday. Rhode Island broke their single game free throw record, shot 92.6%, best in program history. And this year, as we talked about, free throw shooting has been a positive for Rhode Island. In this game, 12 of 14. Johns driving, he lost the dribble. Diving forward is Thomas, but Baldwin able to pick it back up. VCU, though, has to work quickly. 6 seconds to shoot. Back to Shriver. Nunn now driving. The kick out. Banks, the three, missed the rim.
And that might have been the best defensive possession I've seen Rhode Island play all year, Zach. That was great help side, and nobody lost their guy. Great job by Rhode Island, as now Sebastian Thomas in a little bit of trouble, and a timeout. But we'll keep it right here as Sebastian Thomas is now grimacing in pain, and oh boy, this is not good. I tell you what, there is some conflict over there as both benches are fully up. Sebastian Thomas really limping off the court right now, and that is not what you want to see for Rhode Island. I'm not sure what happened, but boy, he is in a lot of pain, Zach.
Well, let's take you back that last sequence. Thomas was racing up the floor. He lost his balance. Called timeout to maintain possession, and yeah, he just twisted it awkwardly.
Saw it. Oh, man. You saw it right before he went down. He twisted that ankle. He was able to call timeout.
And but, again, you don't have Brown Freeman the rest of the year. Sebastian Thomas in the starting lineup. Who do you turn to if you don't have him?
That's a great question, Zach. I mean, honestly, it's got to be Weston, I think, at this point. He comes in, and you know, now you're down two guys. Obviously, as you know, as you see there, Sebastian Thomas is heading to the locker room. And let's take a look here, though, at a more positive side of things. Ishmael Leggett, 13 points. The first one, that ankle breaker, knocking down the three. He's been great from the charity stripe. He's been good inside. Right here, you see the little tip to himself, put back for two. And Ishmael Leggett has been doing it all again. Just so great off the ball, drawing the contact, the hoop, the harm, and the holler. And he's been good as we are back to action here in Kingston.
Well, Rhode Island looking to figure it out as the injury bug is beginning to hit this one. 7-point Rhode Island lead under 2 minutes to go. Brandon Weston is in the game for Rhodey. Chiku nearly had it poked away. 5 seconds to shoot. Handoff. Martin, 2 seconds to shoot. Has to put it up, and he didn't get it off in time. Shot clock violation on the Rams. And again, no Sebastian Thomas now for the Rams of Rhode Island. That is 6 points in his 18 minutes, 2 assists. Could be a big loss for the Rams, who essentially are out of point guard depth.
Yeah, now you got to turn to, in my mind, the guys on the court, it's either going to be Leggett or Jalen Carey handling the basketball here.
On the other end, Banks hands to Nunn. Baldwin, his only 2 points are off free throws. There's a screen there by Johns that kept Leggett away from him. But the stop still from Rhode Island. Coming back to the ball is Brandon Weston. Not a lot to talk about in this game, just one shot, no points so far. 10 minutes of action. Wide open was Chiku underneath. Leggett finds him, the pass bounces off the rim. Offline there from Leggett. And then a lot of contact on the other end. Just none had a good look.
Right there, Leggett giving up his body. No easy baskets right there. Certainly did not want to give anybody any easy layups. But as you mentioned, it's been a struggles here to say the least.
How about this? Rhode Island, no field goals in nearly 6 minutes.
Yeah. It's been all free throws pretty much from Ish Leggett.
Meanwhile, VCU, they haven't scored at all in 2 minutes, 17 seconds. Oh, and that doesn't change here. Missed free throw on the 1-1. Rhode Island maintains their 7-point lead as we're under a minute left to go in the first. Jalen Carey handling it here for the Rams. They'll likely see some extended point guard minutes if Thomas can't return. Chiku pushes it back to Leggett. Feed inside. Chiku can't get it to go. Shriver pulls it down on the board. About a 5 or so second difference between the shot clock and the game clock here for VCU. To the corner. Banks floats it up ahead. Johns to the bucket. He gets fouled. Shot clock now off with 24 seconds.
Right now, Rhode Island with that 7-point lead, Zach, is this is a 24 seconds that's going to matter here. If he knocks down both of his free throws, obviously then you got an opportunity to just slow it down, don't rush it, and get one last shot here before halftime.
VCU now in the double bonus. Johns is at the line. He hasn't gone yet in this game. Over 77% this year. He misses his first. But we talked about, he scored 7 of VCU's first 8 points in this game. He's been largely quiet since he's now at 9. Nunn will head to the bench. Zeb Jackson back on for VCU. Their scoring drought is 2 minutes 51 seconds. That snapped here. Johns hits the second half. 6-point roadie lead, and they'll have the last shot if they want it. Press here from VCU in the backcourt. Jalen Carey will bring it up. Can Rhode Island get the final shot here in the first half?
This is where you got to be careful not to be too laid back if you're Jalen Carey.
6 seconds. Carey gets separation, takes the three, and it comes up short. Chiku tries to bat it in, and that'll do it for the first half. Rhode Island has led for all but 54 seconds here in the first. And right now, they have a 6-point lead going to the locker room.
Yeah, well, Rhode Island right now up by 6. That is huge. You saw Archie Miller, even though right there he misses that last second opportunity, they love it. Archie Miller says, guys, let's focus on the good. We are up 6 against the best team in the conference, and we'll send it over to Paige Messier.
I'm with assistant coach Austin Carroll. Now, this VCU team, they played really well on the road, 5 wins in a row, but you guys kind of shut down their offense with your defense. How have you guys done that so effectively?
Yeah, I thought we did a good job with our defense. We had great intensity to start the game. I thought it went down a little bit as the half went on, but we got to put together a second half, and we should be in a good spot here at the end of the game.
Perfect. A lot of uncertainty in the past week, especially with Sebastian Thomas now with a possible injury. But having a constant like Ishmael Leggett playing great in the first half, how much confidence does that give you?
I can't say enough good things about Ish on offense, on defense, what he brings to us on and off the court. He's a stud, and he's been a pleasure to coach the last 3 years.
Thank you, coach.
You're welcome.
Back to you.
Back ahead of the start of the second half, Rhode Island up by 6 over VCU. Zach Austin, Noah McClain, Paige Messier on the call. And Noah, we talked about a little earlier in this broadcast, when you look to the schedule, you know, Rhode Island against some high-ranking teams in the A-10 in this building, they've done fairly well, and that's been the case in the first half.
Well, you're absolutely right, Zach. I don't think I could have said it any better right there, as Rhode Island here in the Ryan Center has played some very good basketball against some very good teams, and they're showing off their best of the best right now here in the first half. Now, the question is, can they do it for the second half? We talked about this earlier in the first, Zach, that this Rhode Island team has been in a lot of very close games. Here's a couple of looks at A-10 standings right here. VCU at the top. This is a very, very important game for VCU as Dayton 9-4 in conference, and in conference 9-3 for VCU. So this is a very, very must-win game here.
And remember, Noah, back last Tuesday, VCU lost at home to the Flyers. They split the season series. So that's going to be interesting to watch the rest of the way. Here's the bottom half. Rhode Island third to last. They got a game against UMass next up on Saturday. Well, good news for Rhode Island injury, right? Sebastian Thomas is on the court to begin the second half with the rest of the starters. VCU looks to be without Deloach for the moment. He went down with a pretty serious looking knee injury. Again, not sure what his status is, but right now not on the floor for VCU. In his place is David Shriver. We are back underway here in the second half. Both offenses were fairly stagnant heading into the locker room. Be interesting to see how they respond here, as that's a 3-pointer off the back iron and no good for Jaden Nunn. Rebound taken by Rhode Island and Jalen Carey. Again, that first half, Rhode Island outscored VCU by 6. First time they had a positive scoring margin in a half since the second half against LaSalle in that comeback win. Is looking for Chiku. That pass is intercepted all the way to the bucket, trying to kiss it off the window, but unable to do so is Ace Baldwin, who again, just 2 points as that one up ahead for Chiku. A little too far, but ultimately the offensive foul at the end of it.
That's like the fourth time tonight, Zach, that we have seen a wide open layup opportunity for a big man, and either a bad pass or unable to hang on to it by the big man. But he was all alone down there. And once again, these are points that you need to capitalize on against a very good VCU team like this.
Again, another thing Archie Miller emphasized earlier this week was turnovers as well. VCU tends to force a lot of them. But both teams fairly clean in this game. 8 for Rhode Island and 5 for VCU here in the first half. And some changes. Johns had the defender right in his face. That was Martin. Lost it, but the feed underneath. And the following layup, good for Kern. VCU gets the first bucket of half number 2.
Cutting that Rhode Island lead down to 4. As we'll see if Rhode Island can have an answer.
Both teams around the same from the floor. Rhode Island 33% now. VCU at a clip of 32 as Leggett tried to make something happen, maybe a little indecisive, and ultimately floated out of bounds. So we'll look at that last bucket. And Johns had Martin all in his face, able to split the defenders, and then the back door and the finish from Kern. Ace Baldwin in this game, 0 of 6 from the floor. He's only tried 1-3, but he's 2 of 2 from the free throw line. Here's a 3 for Ace, unable to get that one. Now make it 0 of 7 for Baldwin. The Rams have done their job on him to this point, but still a lot of basketball left to play. Being the home Rams as Martin fakes. Carey waves off Thomas. Chiku to Leggett. Leggett. 9 seconds now, 8 to shoot for Rhode Island. The feed for Chiku. The layup, good, and the foul.
And that's such a huge basket right there for Rhode Island, Zach, because even though you have the lead, the momentum was all to VCU, and if you don't get a good look right there, then things can turn away. Let's take another look at it right here. You see Jalen Carey, such a good distributor, and finishing through the contact there, Chiku, and he's got a chance at the old-fashioned three-point play.
Chiku, the transfer of Alabama out of Paris, France, redshirt sophomore season. 6'11", 230, big presence inside for the Rams this year. 64.2% from the line and couldn't make that one, so just a regular two-point play for Chiku. He's now at 4 points. Watkins couldn't find an opening, kicks out. Shriver, that shot was deflected, but VCU still with it. Brandon Johns inside. He's got Chiku all over him. And ultimately an over-the-back foul on Chiku.
And Johns has had his way inside all night, Zach. He's been very, very active. He's good at that separation. He just needs a little bit right there. He does enough where he doesn't lead with the shoulder, but he separates and goes above that time drawing the contact.
Well, that was Chiku's third foul, so it looks like Abdu Sam is set to check in at the next whistle. Brandon Johns is back at the line, already in double figures with 10. And he's now 1 of 3 from the free throw line. This is his first.
And this ruckus crowd here at Kingston, Rhode Island, as they call it, really letting them hear it. And you gotta love the energy here in the Ryan Center tonight for a big game for both teams here in the A-10.
Johns lands his second, so makes the second half. We've seen a lot of that, a lot of the first shots being missed here in this one. Lead for Rhodey is 5, 32 to 27. Carey working around the active hands of Jameer Watkins. Sam cuts the basket. Here comes Leggett in the paint. Right hand hook shot is good. And in the quick steal, he caught him sleeping. Going up and in, Ishmael Leggett. What a play for the Rhode Island Rams.
And that is just great heads-up basketball there. That is just absolute dog mentality there from Leggett. Great job to extend this lead. 36-27 Rams on top.
Big swing in favor of Rhode Island. How does VCU respond? Well, they're going to get it to Johns. Guarded by Adu Sam. Martin trying to swat it away. John's able to go up and finish on the layup. 7-point roadie lead. And it's been about seven, really, this whole game since they've been up, Noah.
Yeah, it really has kind of stuck at that number.
No huge runs. We saw a 6-0 run for Rhode Island. May have been 8-0, actually, earlier in that first half as an offensive foul. They're off the ball. We'll turn it over. How about this sequence? Look how quick this happened. Leggett drives in, does the rest afterwards.
Yeah, great job by Leggett. Once again, you saw the initial one and then goes back for more. He was hungry and still wanted to eat and does exactly that.
17
points. He is so fun to watch.
In 22 minutes for Ishmael Leggett. Oh, near steal by Carey. Batted out of bounds. And last touch by Nunn. It'll go to Rhode Island. How about that play by Jalen Carey? Forced the turnover. 7 on VCU. Rhodey now at 10. Rhodey now 41% from the field. Thomas distributes a carry. He lost the dribble on the ground. And looks like it's going to be a jump ball. Arrow favors Rhode Island. They'll keep possession. We're heading to the media timeout. Rhode Island picking up where they left off. Good one here at the Ryan Center. 36-29. Second half. Back at the Ryan Center. Rhode Island up by 7, but a big reason why VCU's still in the game. Their big man, graduate transfer out of Michigan, is Brandon Johns. He got it started early, and he's been a steady presence throughout.
Yeah, Brandon Johns, so good on all sides of the ball. You saw right there going up for the layup. He's done it all tonight. He's shot it from downtown. He's worked so well inside. His patience, his footwork, and just his absolute tenacity around the rim, his drive to score the basketball has led him to a very productive night. And the real reason, as you just mentioned, Zach, why VCU is still within striking distance of Rhode Island.
Again, Brandon Johns is not a new name for Rhodey head coach Archie Miller. Faced off against him plenty of times during his Indiana days. In fact, he went 0-5 against Michigan as the Hoosiers head coach. There's a foul on the other end. VCU, though, when he was with Dayton, is also a program that gave him some troubles. He's 3-4 in his career against the VCU Rams. As Leggett will go right back to the free throw line. In this building, though, in the all-time series, Rhode Island, or I should say here at home in this building, Rhode Island 5-2 against VCU as Leggett sinks his first. Ishmael Leggett looking for his 19th points. He gets it there, and it's now a full 9-point lead, 29-38. Again, VCU without Jalen Deloach, relying on David Shriver here in his absence. Ace Baldwin has not had a large scoring output in this game to this point. Shriver up fakes, finds Johns. Feed it underneath, now the kick out. Three-pointer, that bit no good. And it looks to stay with VCU. Archie Miller's trying to argue for a shot clock violation.
Yeah, that ball did not hit the rim right there. That should be a shot clock violation.
I thought that may have kissed off the front just barely. And that must be what the officials saw. It was very close. It certainly wasn't all that obvious, but I did catch that a little bit at the end. Regardless, VCU retains possession. Into the game for the first time is Toby Lawal. Again, with Deloach out looking for options off the bench. There's a steal for Rhode Island. Sebastian Thomas comes up with it. Thomas, the feed, and Martin unable to get it out of bounds. Toby Lawal is a freshman out of London, England. This is his 18th game of the year. He's not played since January 20th.
Next guy up, Zach. We've said it quite a few times for different reasons, but same mentality, same thing.
Of course, another native of London, England here in this game is Rory Stewart. We have not seen him yet so far for Rhode Island. Of course, had that big outing against St. Louis. Career high 11 points. Did not miss from the field in that one. But overall, in his freshman year, very limited. 5 seconds on the shot clock for Carey. He fires up a three, fading away, no. And Johns skies up for the rebound. Birdie still up 9. Nunn had an opening. Here's Baldwin trying to weave through everybody, going to the bucket, can't get the bounce to go. Still scoreless from the field. He's now 0 of 9.
This is unbelievable. I've never seen anything like this as Thomas knocks it down. Sebastian Thomas, how do you do? A three ball extends the lead, and we got ourselves a timeout.
Well, his ankle looks fine out there. No, he just got a big play for Rhode Island, their largest lead of the night. Thomas from the corner. Rams up by 12 here in the second half. Fans are loving it here in Kingston, Rhode Island, their largest lead of the night. And a big reason why, Noah, is Sebastian Thomas.
You're absolutely right. Sebastian Thomas has been phenomenal. He came back despite some adversity early on. You see there the three ball getting his night started there. He's done it all around, though, finishing through contact, getting to the lane. He distributes it so well, moves off the ball. You see him there knocking down another three, and he has continued to be phenomenal for Rhode Island.
Meanwhile, on the other end, Ace Baldwin, he's 0 of 9 from the floor. Archie Miller described him as the engine that makes this team go. And right now, the engine has not started for VCU.
And that's why they're down so much as they are right now, Zach.
Brandon Johns, 13 points, only one in double digits for VCU. Ish Leggett with 19 for Rhode Island, 5 on the shot clock, straightaway jumper, make it 0 of 10 for Baldwin. And, you know, every player has an off night, but you don't see this very often for someone like Ace Baldwin. Thomas fires it outside for Leggett. Able to get to the ball, trying to shake the ankles of Banks. That three, though, rims out.
And nearly had himself another highlight reel right there.
Driving is Watkins, and he's fouled on the way there. Abdu Sam in the way, and that's his third. So now you have Chiku with three, and there's a look at Jalen Deloach on the VCU bench. He was spotted with crutches. Of course, has that big wrap on the left knee. Doesn't look like he's coming back.
Oh, he's certainly not coming back, Zach. But we just, again, hope and pray that his recovery is A-OK speedy. But he's here nonetheless, cheering on VCU, his squad, as they take on Rhode Island here. They trail 29-41.
VCU has not scored in nearly three and a half. Trout extends past 3 minutes, 20 seconds. Spinning around, Jackson finds Shriver. He makes a move around Martin, nearly gets the layup to go, but just bounces out. Coast to coast, Sebastian Thomas, but it's rejected out of bounds by Watkins.
And here comes Rory Stewart for the first time, but how about that elevation on that last play, rising well above the rim and absolutely rejected. Let's take another look at it. Thomas thinks he's getting an easy layup and instead is met by Watkins, who says, hey, you're home, but my house.
15 blocks going into tonight for Watkins on the season. And again, Rory Stewart in the game. You figure with three fouls now for both the main big men options for the Rams that he would get some time. And here he is in the second half. Swing pass looking back for Stewart. He can shoot the three ball. We'll see if they set up a look for him. Leggett at the elbow. Thomas has got 6 seconds on the shot clock. Back to Carey. Carey trying to find room in the paint. And with 1 second left on the shot clock, a foul call.
It's going to be off the knee actually there of Jalen Carey, says the official.
So Shriver again trying to take some of the load off without Deloach. He's also scoreless in this game. 0 of 4 from the floor. Three of those four have been from distance. And again, that's something he does well. So not only if the Rhode Island Rams defended Baldwin well, but they've kept him off the scoreboard, that being Shriver as well. Here's Banks being bumped by a couple Rhode Island Rams to the bucket. Watkins can't finish, but Lawal can. That's Toby Lawal, averaging just 1.5 points per game with a huge dunk.
Every point is important, but throw it down with authority, big fella, bringing the VCU bench to their feet.
10-point roadie lead here over first place VCU. In contact, kick out, Martin from the corner, he got it. Malik Martin for three, and now Rhode Island's largest lead of the night at 13.
That Rhode Island bench loving it right now.
Trying to split the defense, and doing so there is Zeb Jackson, quiets the crowd. Carey able to cross midcourt. And VCU has gone deep to their bench in this game, not something they always do. The likes of Lawal, who And Jackson, who falls down there. Thomas, another three that time, though, off the backboard. Stewart, big rebound for the Rams of Rhode Island.
Jalen Carey's got his shoe untied, doesn't even know it. Now he realizes. Sebastian Thomas is going to give him a minute.
Carey gets back up, gets the basketball, nearly slips. Fade away, no. Stewart, though, bats it in the air, right in the Watkins hands. One-on-one of the bucket, banks, gets the layup. 4 points now off the bench for Josh Banks. Lead slowly. VCU trying to get back into a down nine. Here's Stewart. He's bumped a couple times. He'll go up with it, and he's fouled.
That's huge for Rory Stewart. This is an opportunity to just get himself going as we got a timeout. Right now, though, Rhode Island 44 up 35 as the finish put back with authority. We'll be back in just a moment.
Well, Rhode Island's had some special guests. We got another one. Let's go down to Paige with more.
Thank you, Zach. I'm with Jeff Dowen, a former Ram. Now he's on the Raptors. You're back Rhode Island. What did you miss most about this place?
Just the atmosphere and the fans. You know, I'm glad to be back. Good seeing a lot of familiar faces. I just miss playing in this arena, so I'm glad I was able to come back and just show some love.
Yeah, and then you're on to the NBA now. What did Rhode Island teach you for you to be prepared for that moment?
Just be ready when your name is called. The NBA is definitely a big business. I have to be ready no matter what. I'm always practicing on my skills and staying focused and always in the gym. And I think Rhode Island has prepared me for that.
And what's your favorite Rhode Island memory? It could be game, campus life, anything.
Winning the A-10 regular season championship my sophomore year. We were ranked top 25 in the country, and just being able to go back to the tournament, it was really amazing.
Thank you, Jeff.
Thank you, Paige. That was great. And again, we've been spoiled this year, Noah, here at the Ryan Center, as Rory Stewart misses the second of two free throws.
Yeah, we really have. We've seen some big faces come to this gym. Jimmy Butler, Ray Allen, just to name a few. Of course, Jeff Doughton back here in the Ryan Center tonight.
And Doughton spending years here, successful years with the Rams, as that's batted out of bounds. And again, this is just ahead of Saturday's game. We have a couple teams getting their names up here in the Ryan Center. Just great to see all the former players coming back and being honored. Doughton now a two-way contract with Toronto, spending some time with Raptors 905 as well in the G League. Rhode Island getting that big turnover on the other end. Here they are with the basketball. Leggett makes a move, cut off by Johns. He'll float it all the way to the corner. Thomas from the free throw line. Leggett sends it up and can't get it to go. And an offensive foul as Weston tried to go for the rebound.
I'm in disbelief right there. I would love to see that again as Archie Miller just gives Weston the, hey, you did absolutely nothing wrong right there. And this entire crowd was in disbelief that that was called an offensive foul.
We're already still up by 10, but VCU's made all three of their last three shots. Jackson driving around Thomas, able to split two defenders and able to go to the bucket. Jackson now in the game there is his second bucket. Here's the press that VCU has done all year long.
They're getting into crunch time. You're probably going to see some more pressure here from VCU down the stretch.
Thomas near side to Stewart. Straight away three. Can't get that one to fall. It goes out of bounds and it's a stay with the Rams of Rhode Island.
Yeah, right there. Rory Stewart doesn't knock that down, but I like that shot for him. That's a shot that he will make, and he's going to have to get his confidence up because right now guys are just going to have, you know, like we just heard Weston's talk about, you know, you never know when your name is going to be called, and got to take advantage of it.
Rams trying to get something going. They've missed six of their last seven shots, and they haven't hit a field goal in 3 minutes. Thomas all the way from the logo. Here's Martin. Thomas, open look from three in the air. And Stewart couldn't pull it down. Jackson just too strong. Here's Kern, lane to the bucket, and he lays it through. There's Nick Kern. He's been doing it all game long. Going right to the bucket, and he gets another two. How about the feed for Stewart? It gets closed off quickly. Out of bounds. Will stay with Rhode Island.
And that's going to be it for Rory Stewart for the time being. Let's take a look, though, at the coast-to-coast bucket here. As you see VCU in transition. Kern going all the way in easy elevation for two. So now the score, 45, Rhode Island, VCU with 39.
VCU's offense is heating up. They've made all five of their last five shots. Rhode Island hasn't hit one in a bit. Now they haven't scored in over 2 minutes. Leggett looking to change that here. 19 points in this game. Feed again looking inside for Chiku. And no, we've seen that all game long. They just haven't been able to connect on those passes. We'll head to a timeout. Rhode Island up by six, but VCU slowly creeping back here in the second. Well, VCU hasn't had the best night shooting, but right now they're on a hot streak. Five of their last five, it's got them back in this game down six.
Yeah, VCU suddenly, all of a sudden, the heat has been turned up here in the Ryan Center. Like you mentioned, five of their last five, some authority in the last few minutes here as it's been getting to the rim with a fairly easy, not a lot to speak for the defense, which has been so good for Rhode Island in this game. But Kern, you see there on the transition bucket, getting fired up. And right now, this VCU team has clawed their way back, Zach, here to only being down six after trailing between that 7-10 mark all game long.
And Noah, they've done this, as you can see, without Jalen Deloach since the first half and with very minimal production from Ace Baldwin, who still has yet to make a field goal in this game. He's 0 for 10 from the field. He's tried three threes, hasn't gotten any to go in 26 minutes. Leads everybody and just nothing going for him.
It's really been such an interesting thing here as Shriver and as you mentioned there as well, Baldwin, both struggling and both, as you mentioned, I'm going to use your analogy again, the engine to this car here that goes. And right now, the car really hasn't started. So,
and, you know, we talked about Brandon Johns. He's been good, but he hasn't had a huge run of points since early in the game, as there's 6 of 6 now for VCU. And it's really been a team effort in that last stretch. We've seen Jackson making plays, Kern making plays. He had that dunk a little earlier ago from Lawal, who hasn't played in weeks. Now Rhode Island only leads by 4 after that last bucket. VCU's run is 6 over a minute and a half. Rhode Island hasn't scored in nearly 3 minutes. There's Weston's attempt to break that. It's no good. VCU can make it a one-possession game. Jackson fakes on the three, drives to the bucket, and he's going to get fouled.
Yeah, right there. That wasn't a great look on the other end for Rhode Island. And then on the defensive end, you know, not the greatest thing. But let's just take another look at the bucket right out of the timeout for VCU. Just a great heads-up play there. The backdoor cut. And Zeb Jackson easily finishing there as he is headed to the free throw line right now for two free ones.
His first trip, junior out of Michigan. Out of Toledo, Ohio, misses his first. 78% on the year, and it's Ish Leggett now back in the ballgame for a roadie. And we've seen this really know all game. VCU has struggled on their free throw, especially on the first on these trips. They're 10 of 18 now in this game, make it 11 of 19. Something that head coach Mike Rhodes says they've been working on, but has certainly not been a strength in this game. And here's a press trapped in the corner, and Carey able to get it away. VCU has also only forced 12 turnovers for Rhodey as they're on a 7-0 run. Martin from the near side, now into the corner. Carey, and he's bumped. VCU picks up the foul.
And Martin, you know, one thing to note, Zach, is Martin has been very quiet this game. He has not really had his presence in either the rebounding column or the scoring column. You know, obviously, you'll take a look at the numbers for him tonight as he was able to get that over to Jalen Carey, who got fouled, but he needs to step in and make an impact.
Well, no, he's been quiet, but he does have 5 points, and he leads all Rams on Rhode Island with 8 rebounds. Carey is able to kick it out to Martin. Thomas finds a cutting Martin in the lane. He lost it out of bounds. It's going to go to VCU. Offensive foul. That was on Martin, as VCU also now, they're run 11-1 over the last 5 minutes. Brody has not scored once they get the ball back in over 4 minutes.
Been a long scoring drought for Rhode Island. They need a defensive stop here. Get the ball back and get into your stuff.
Well, the game has swung in the favor of VCU. And there's an exclamation point from Brandon Johns. It's a 1-point game here at the Ryan Center, 45-44, and this game has flipped on its head. It's now VCU's offense that has taken charge. 6 minutes left to go. Thomas gets it back on the handoff. Leggett. It's been quiet lately in this game. Oh, he does have 19. Driving baseline, Carey goes up, gets the bucket, and the foul.
Jalen Carey doing exactly what he needs. Let's take a look, though, on the other end first. This is a talk about authority. My goodness. Throw it down, Johns. And then, as we mentioned right there, Jalen Carey at the free throw line after he knocks down through the contact the layup, and a much-needed basket for Rhode Island. 8 points on the night for Carey.
Carey looking to make it a 3-point play, can't, and Shriver pulls down the board, and that's something on the other end. Rhode Island really hasn't been able to capitalize on those opportunities tonight. VCU has made their last 7 shots, yet Ace Baldwin has not gotten going yet. And if that happens, Rhode Island could be in trouble. To the bucket, slam down by Watkins.
And Archie Miller is throwing his hands up like, guys, this is unbelievable. It's just been dunk after dunk. Who's going to step up and play some defense?
Back to one. Rhodey's still on top. Missed 6 of their last 7 shots. Jackson keeping up with Thomas. 8 seconds to shoot. Looking for somebody. Gets it to the corner. Leggett with Baldwin all over him. He lost it. VCU takes it away, and now a chance to take the lead on this possession.
And watch for a pull-up there, if I was going to say there, from Shriver, who's still good off the ball.
Here's Shriver for 3. No lead that time. Miss for Shriver. He's now 0-4 from distance.
I had a feeling they wanted to get it into his hands, but a big defensive stop there for Rhode Island. Need to get a bucket here and crunch time.
Again, Rhode Island is 1 of their last 7. Thomas looking for Chiku, nearly batted out of bounds by Johns, and it was, but it was last touch by Johns, and he can't believe that call. He thought it was off Chiku. As we'll take a look at that last dunk, here's Watkins going up strong. Dusan will check in, and Archie Miller will use a timeout. Oh, we're nearing crunch time. Got a good one in Kingston. Rams up by 1. It's a 1-point game here in Kingston, and VCU, they've been on a roll, Noah, and they've gone strong to the rim. They've really had their way up there so far.
They really have. 8 of their last 9 field goals have come from the dunking area of this game. And my goodness, they have been able to have their way with Rhode Island, which has been not the case in the first half. Sack Rhode Island, good defense, but not in the last few minutes, as once again, the elevation and sending that VCU bench into an absolute shockwave after that last one. They are within 1. Rhode Island with the basketball, 10 to shoot here on the shot clock.
VCU has made 8 of their last 9. Rhode has missed 6 of their last 7. Thomas will float it up and can't get the roll. Last time these two teams played here in this building, it was a 1-point decision. 63-62 in favor of VCU. It's a 1-point game here right now in the second half, with Rhode on top. Baldwin still just 2 points. VCU's offense picking up regardless to get it into the hands of Brandon Johns. Banks, no opening for him. Five on the shot clock. Nearly batted away by Sam, but just couldn't time it up. There's a layup for VCU, and there's their first lead in a long time. 8-6 was their last lead in this game. Now up 48-47 with 3:27 in the second half. Their run is 13-2.
It's been all VCU in the last few minutes, Zach.
And you figure for a team like VCU, it's only a matter of time before they heat up, but Rhode Island responds right back. Jalen Carey gets back on the board.
So composed, Zach. You see him, he just rises up and he just jogs back and now grinds in on the defensive end. Huge shot.
Before that possession, Rhode Island had been scoreless for over 2 minutes. And we're going to have a dogfight the rest of the way between these two teams. Johns going up strong. He's fouled. And Abdu Sam pats his chest saying, my bad.
Yeah, and you know, right there, though, I don't mind that because it's been a dunk clinic here for VCU. And right there, make him earn it. VCU, normally a team that has had a lot of guys do things very well, but you talk about there's been some uncharacteristic stat lines for VCU tonight, and this ruckus crowd is going to let him hear it.
Well, one not uncharacteristic stat line is Brandon Johns. 15 points, make it 16 on the free throw, as Nick Kern Jr., who had four fouls, was out of the game, will come back in. Banks got an extended run in his place, that being Josh Banks. 4 points in 14 minutes, heads to the bench.
Johns 3-for-5 from the line tonight. And every free throw is big as this one knotted up at 49. He's got one more.
VCU, their leading point scorer tonight, gets both on that try. He's up to 17. And the lead is back in favor of VCU. 50-49. We're under 3 minutes left to play. And Carey lost the ball. VCU open lane. Martin trying to disrupt it. He got the foul. VCU trying to go for another dunk.
Great job by Malik Martin. He goes back, and that right there is what is why I love Malik Martin, Zach, because he's not going to let it. Let's watch this again. What looks like is going to be an easy dunk. Malik Martin disrupts and does a wonderful job. You saw the fan reaction right there. Said, hey, I'm not going to give you anything easy.
Yeah, that's exactly your point, Noah, making him earn it. Biggest free throws perhaps of the game for VCU. It's Watkins at the line, and his first bounces off.
That's huge.
That's why you foul in that situation. Watkins trying to make the second half in this game. He's 1 of 3, make it 2 of 4.
VCU is in the bonus. That's something important to mention the rest of the way here as they now are up by 2.
Chica re-enters with 3 fouls. Sam will sit. Thomas nearly lost it out of bounds, and he did. Costly mistake for Rhode Island as he lost his balance, touched the line.
And these are little things that really hurt Rhode Island, and this has been a theme here, Zach, for this Rhode Island men's basketball team. Is down the stretch, they've had trouble closing out games. They trail by 2 right now.
Johns spinning in the paint, lays it up, and a traveling call.
Well, I guess nobody wants to take care of the basketball here in the last few minutes.
VCU now in double digits with 10 turnovers as Mike Rhodes is trying to argue for a travel and going the other way, and he's not going to get it. He is irate on that VCU bench. Baldwin pressing on Leggett. He'll pass it over to Thomas to cross into the front court. We're under 2.5 to go. VCU, the 2-point lead after trailing for almost the entire game. Already had led for over 32 minutes. 8 seconds to shoot. Carey. He'll back up. Johns on him. The 3-pointer. Yes. Jalen Carey puts Rhode Island back on top.
That's a big bucket for Rhode Island, and this crowd really getting into it. Gotta get a stop here if you're Rhode Island.
VCU looking to respond as we are in crunch time. Watkins races by everyone, can't get the layup to go. He missed it, he had a good look. didn't have enough on it. Now Rhode Island has the lead and the basketball.
This is where Rhode Island, Zach, has to be very composed. Slow it down, run the shot clock down, and get a great look.
Thomas finds Leggett cutting inside the feed. Martin couldn't go up with it. Rejected by VCU. And they get the stop they needed. Crowd not happy. Here's a three for Watkins. Martin secures the board. Poked away, but a foul by Jackson. And he can't believe it.
Jackson very upset right there, as Thomas doing a nice job. Let's watch this Jalen Carey three ball again. Just settles right into it with a hand in his face nonetheless. It doesn't matter, Jalen Carey came to play tonight.
Big swish from Jalen Carey, who's now at 13 points on the night. Coming off a Rhode Island career best, and again, in an increased role without Breon Freeman, stepped up to the plate.
We are into crunch time, under a minute. Rams, Rhode Island Rams, that is, up by one with the basketball.
And after that big stretch for VCU, they haven't hit a field goal now in over 2.5 minutes. Thomas, 8 seconds to shoot. He fires it to the corner, and no one's there waiting for it. VCU a chance with 40 ticks left on the clock.
And that is another very costly mistake, as we are going to keep it right here, a VCU timeout. But Zach, that is exactly where you need to have, in my opinion, don't throw that pass. Look at Archie Miller right now, though, as he is telling his guys, we got to figure this out. That is an uncostly error, as right now, that's where you want to see somebody go to the basket, especially Malik Martin, in my opinion, just such a strong guy. We've seen him be successful underneath before, but it's crunch time. What do you need to see from VCU here, Zach?
Well, again, they were looking for Martin on the other end. They got a big chance, and you got to wonder, Noah, do they go to Baldwin? It hasn't been his night, but he's led the way for them with 33 minutes played. It seems like a matter of time. You just got to keep getting it to him.
It's either going to be him, but in my opinion right now, the guy with the hot hand is Brandon Johns Jr. He's been phenomenal all night long, and he's been very, very dominant in the paint, Zach. Rhode Island has not really had an answer in the paint, and I think we're going to see something quick to the basket, look for a screen, maybe a kick quick out three ball for David Shriver. I know it hasn't been his night either, but hey, shoot or shoot, and he's on this team for one reason, and that's to shoot the basketball.
Well, we'll see if VCU goes with the hot hand or if they'll go to one of their playmakers or a couple of them that have been there for them all year. Even if they haven't been there tonight, they're still on the floor.
I tell you what though, Zach, boy, have we had a special treat on this Wednesday night here in Kingston. Who would have thought that 52-51 with under a minute.
How about tomorrow night? Another big one for women's basketball. Could be the game of the year in the Atlantic 10. Rhode Island, UMass, tomorrow at 6 p.m. You can get that one right here on Your View New England. Right here, Rhode Island trying to get their third win over a top three team in the Atlantic 10 this year. Remember, they topped the Dayton Flyers in Archie Miller's revenge game, 75-70. They beat Fordham earlier in the year, and here's VCU, biggest possession of the game. Feed from Baldwin. Johns. Jackson to the basket, doesn't get the roll. Watkins, the second effort, and he puts it down. VCU takes the lead.
1 point game, shot clock is off. Archie Miller is gonna let it roll.
It comes down to the final shot, but they're gonna take timeout. Archie Miller gonna draw up what could be the final play of the game with 16.2 ticks on the clock.
And really, that one right there, Rhode Island dodged a bullet on the first one, but couldn't get that rebound, Zach. I thought maybe if Rhode Island comes away with it, then VCU pretty much has to foul right away. And let's watch another look here. And it was the double there. You saw the double team. Watch this. Here's the original layup and some controversy there, as then the second chance opportunity gets the shooter's bounce. Did Jamar Watkins, who gives VCU a 1 point lead. And Rhode Island will have 16 seconds to try and take the lead.
And then Noah, who do you go to here in this situation? Reverse question, you saw VCU, now who do you go if you're Rhodey?
I'm going into the hands of Ishmael Leggett, or and I'm going to have to say Martin inside. He's so strong and just needed something inside and quick.
Yeah, Jalen Carey also in double digits. He had that big three-pointer to retake the lead. Did they go to him again?
Jalen Carey's been great all night long. You know what I love about this team is even though they've had a couple guys shaken up, they're dealing with some adversity, there are guys up and down this roster that can step up big, and Jalen Carey has proven tonight especially that he can be one of those guys, so look for him to definitely be an option.
Well, that last bucket VCU needed dearly. They had been scoreless for almost 2.5 minutes, and now it puts Rhode Island in position to perhaps take the final shot for the game. Rhodey in the Ryan Center this year, 7-5 against VCU. They're 5-2. A chance to snap a three-game losing streak. Meanwhile, VCU, they're trying to get back in the win column. As the officials are telling the Rams to hurry up there for Rhode Island there in the huddle.
And both teams do still have one timeout, Zach.
We'll see if they'll need it. The Rams have the shot clock off. 16.2 seconds left to go. Game's seen 9 lead changes, most of which coming in the last few minutes of this game. Rhode Island had led for 34 minutes in total. Who will close out on top? Thomas, dangerous pass. And here we go. In for Leggett. Leggett makes the move, cuts to the basket. He'll lay it high off the window, and it's no good, but he's fouled on the way up. And now Ishmael Leggett will have a chance to potentially take the lead on free throws.
And that is such great leadership from Ishmael Leggett. Watch this, he goes up and the clear contact on that shot. It was the initial contact, but wow, was that initial inbounds play scary, Zach. I thought for sure that that ball was gonna be taken away. Leggett, a chance to tie or take the lead.
And how many times as Leggett makes his first has he seen himself in this position? We saw it earlier this year against Boston College. We've seen it again and again throughout conference play. It lands on his shoulders.
And they're gonna try and ice the shooter. VCU is gonna take their final timeout as this game is tied with 4 seconds, Zach. And how about Ish Leggett stepping up to the free throw line and knocking it down like it's an everyday thing at practice.
And if you're Rhode Island, there's no one else you'd rather have at that line than Ishmael Leggett.
This is your guy. He's been the rock. He's been so good tonight. He's been so good all season long. The Ryan Center is bumping, and this free throw could very much be the decider.
Leggett now 20 points on the night, and what a strange year it's been in the Atlantic 10. Rhode Island on the verge of yet another upset victory. If they can get this to go.
Man, I tell you what, Zach, this team just confuses me at this point. I can't decide what the heck is going on because they can't win on the road. They're phenomenal at the Ryan Center. They've lost to some lower tier teams, so to say. And then all of a sudden they come out and they play so well. Like, where has this been all year? If only they could play like this all the time. But credit to the Rhode Island Rams because it doesn't matter who they're facing. They're going to give you their all. And that's what Archie Miller has talked about all season long. We're just going to focus on us one day at a time and control what we can control.
Well, right now, game is tied. Leggett has one more shot and a chance to take the lead. Biggest free throw, perhaps, of the season for Ishmael Leggett. And it goes. The Rams have retaken the lead. Rhode Island up by one, and now 4.2 seconds. VCU, one last play to draw.
And Rhode Island is going to use their timeout. They want to make sure that they have their best defensive stance here with 4.2. And this place is absolutely rocketing here. This is the type of stuff you saw on TV growing up as a kid, this Ryan Center atmosphere.
VCU is, this season, 9-3 in conference play. They have not lost 2 conference games in a row this year. They've only lost 2 in a row once. That came in early December. Lost at Temple and then to Jacksonville at home. And wow, what a swing this would be if suddenly you're VCU, you find yourself on a 2-game losing streak. But they have a chance here with just over 4 seconds left.
And you're absolutely right. And now, Zach, I'm gonna just go ahead and say, 4.2 seconds. You got time for one play. Who's it going to?
Well, Noah, here's the thing. VCU in this game is 1 of 13 from distance. You don't need a three here, but you have to get something quick. I say you go to Johns.
We'll see. Johns is the guy to receive the inbounds pass, it looks like. Here we go.
Shriver to inbound. Jackson got it. Crosses into the front court. Jackson, the pull-up, and it goes. VCU, what a game winner. And they stun the Rhode Island Rams here in Kingston as time expires.
Wow, talk about a crazy buzzer beater as that shot at the buzzer, and they will take a look at it, but it looked from about every angle that that right there was an absolute heartbreaker for Rhode Island.
The call is confirmed, a stunner here. VCU gets back in the win column in a game where Rhode Island had led for over 34 minutes, and now Rhodey's losing streak is at four. Here's another look.
I mean, that is just crazy right there. Elevated over and hits it at the buzzer. Talk about just a last minute flare for the dramatic right there. Zeb Jackson sends VCU into the win column as they snap their losing streak. Rhode Island continues their four straight losses, 55, VCU 54, Rhode Island the final.
Jackson, 9 points in the final two are the most important. Redshirt sophomore out of Trenton, New Jersey, comes through clutch. He's made plays down the stretch for VCU, and a big win that give them a deep breath of relief with Dayton on their tail in a game that Rhode Island had control.
Yeah, they had control of it all game long, Zach. And if you're Archie Miller and the Rams, that's just a massive punch to the gut. But, you know, you can't be too mad. Well, I shouldn't say that. You're going to be mad regardless of what happens. But this Rhode Island team should keep its head high because they played and competed very, very well with the best team in the A-10. But obviously, right there, VCU shows why they are the best. Zeb Jackson at the buzzer for the win.
Well, it was an off night for most of the night for VCU. But Brandon Johns, 17 points, the game winner from Zeb Jackson. The Rams did their most on offense, but came up just short at the end. It was a good one here in Kingston. VCU survives. For Paige Messier and Noah McClain, I'm Zach Austin. The final from Kingston, VCU 55, Rhode Island 54.